Welcome to The Breakdown, where we break down all the messed up shit. So, Girl Lost is actually a film we already talked about, like, over 100k subscribers ago. YouTube, however, gave me a community guideline strike because most likely I left too much vulgar scenes in the video, such as sex, or even the main character cutting herself. Hopefully, they'll give me a chance with this remake. So Girl Lost is about a young girl named Shara, underage, who is brought into the world of prostitution by her mother. As she notices the disturbing side of selling your body for sex, it really becomes too late for her to save herself from some of the choices made for her. Now, it kinda is like No Child of Mine if y'all ever seen that breakdown. One of the only movies that made me cry, but this is a bit more modern and takes place in Los Angeles. So we gotta bring it back. If you wanna see what happens, including all the messed up parts, stay tuned for the breakdown. Cue to go home. The movie starts off with a girl named Shara washing dishes when some ugly ass dirty dog grabs a hold of her. It seems like he is a companion of her mother, but this damn creep even zips down his pants and offers the girl a 100 if she does the most obvious. Her refusal gets him all grabby, but mom comes in to get his greasy hands off her daughter. Shara runs outside, while inside the man is incredibly disrespectful, as you can hear. Shara opens up a bag with a razor blade in it, showing many wounds that she has given herself. She then cuts herself again, something really new for me to see. The next scene here shows the hard truth of children being exploited around the US, probably the hardest crimes for me to comprehend. After that though, we see Shara sleep, but she is awakened by her mom, who plots to get both their asses out of that house. Well, they end up at a hotel, where the money to pay for the room is to come from a client that the mom gets ready for. Shara does the usual by waiting outside as two clients walk in ready to get a service from mom. So, immediately the next morning, mom and daughter find somewhere else to stay, at the home of Cap here. So, for about $300 a month, they can live in this 5-star establishment. Also, for an extra $100 a month, they can use the laundry room. But mama makes sure to let Cap know they can work something out. Meanwhile outside, Shara is out swimming, and it seems the water is a sort of escape for her. Like how Elvis was an escape for Llewellyn, or the carnival was an escape for Sylvia Likens. Turns out though, she is being watched by this guy named Jamie, the son of Cap, who definitely serves as some kind of romantic interest. He even tries spinning his game at the young Shara at this drunk party, before she is dragged away by mommy. And the next morning, the two women go to another client's place, some rich fella here, who sneaks the mom around the back. After saying how she's a lot older than the 27 she advertised, this damn rich creep talks about how he would like something even younger than that, pointing interest in the daughter in the car. He wants a mother-daughter tag team. But the sad thing is that the mom demands $5,000 for that job, which would be some other time. This particular job lasts until nighttime, and Shara insults mom in anger about how she stinks like she's been ass fucked or something. This is just an invitation to get slapped up by mom though, who retaliates by saying she's a stupid, ungrateful B word. It's okay though, because they make up after fast food is bought. The mom says she's doing this prostitution work for her, but it also seems like she is taking the position of prostitution teacher, letting her daughter know she will teach her the ways of successfully and safely selling her body. Back at the crib, mom fills out another prostitution ad, but then makes Shara pose many different pictures to have for her own ad, ready to condition her daughter for the world's oldest profession. It then seems like someone clicked that ad, because next the mom gets her ready for a job she shouldn't be doing. She tells her daughter, "You gotta do this, because sick fucks will pay double for someone young." They knock on the door and this perv opens it. He locks the door and leads the young girl in through the room filled with stuff that shows he is a family man. He gives her some blow to loosen her strings and spots her a 100 if she gets up and dances for him, which we painfully have to see through the eyes of a sick pervert. This scene about ends once he takes her dress off, but this is so far the most explicit child prostitution scene I've ever seen. After the job, Jamie pours his heart out to the girl. It seems like he really likes her by his words, and his words get them into a full-fledged couple as we see here. She gladly takes a hit of meth, while Cap watches like it's porn. Later, while in the shower, Cap comes in to piss. He instead just sits there, scaring her by tearing the curtains. All he does is sit there singing some slow song. But surprisingly, the mom is right outside and stops Jamie from coming in, saying, we can use the kitchen and laundry, don't go in yet. Meaning she's letting her daughter be abused, for the lack of a better word. Well, Jamie drags her out and kicks his dad's ass, escaping at night to a motel to get away from those two. So the mom gets mad when her daughter is grabbed, but she will happily let her daughter be used just to use a damn washing machine. But back with the couple, as Jamie goes out to buy some alcohol, Shara sits in the shower, cutting herself again. She later gets back in bed with her boyfriend, who seems to notice it, but otherwise ignores it. Later at the beach, he tells her that the plan is to move forward together, and I got a place we can work. This place is, I don't know, some gambling club place? I don't know. Looks like Shara will be one of those bunny waitresses while Jamie helps around, but he notices that boss here is putting away money. Maybe a potential heist will be planned. On another workday, Shara is disrespected by this fat tub of lard who fingers her. She takes his money because her reasoning is, he used my body, so I get his money. But this just gets her held back and fired by the boss. She returns to the motel in a tantrum, eventually getting her razor blade out. Jamie later gets home mad as hell that she supposedly messed up her job or whatever. She tells exactly what happened, but he just calls her a whore who should stick to whoring, knowing all about the prostitution her mom put her through, but has no sympathy. He even calls her a psychopath for all those cuts on her, and leaves her behind breaking down. That meth must have fucked his mind up or something. But I say he is worthy of receiving a 100% full power Delaware smash. Later, he goes to steal that money in the safe, but he gets found out and beat with a bat. I don't know if he died or not, but who cares really? The next morning, Shara wakes up and goes back to Cap's place, but we see her unworried mom whoring out with Cap. This scene definitely reminds me of No Child of Mine, but if anybody is a whore, I'd say it's the mom. She should be out like, I don't know, like maybe looking for her damn child, but she don't care. She lets her almost get taken advantage of for a damn washing machine. Shara walks around all night with nowhere to go, but is creeped on by this random man. He lets her in and gives her money for sex. She can either give it back or be stranded and broke, but we see what choice she takes. Jamie later gets kicked out by the people he tried to rob. He definitely got a beating he deserved for saying such harsh words. The next morning, Shara takes a bus to the house that we saw in the beginning. You know, the one that belonged to that creep. The creep finds her in the back, and she asks for a place to stay. Well, to get that, C is subject to a disturbing scene of rough sex from him. Y'all don't need to see that. But after, she uses the internet to find some kind of escort service. This site looks sketchy as hell, and it's obviously a place for young child sex workers. She gets off the laptop once the creeper comes in, telling her that she feels they have a connection, and that age is just a number. This scene escalates into a pretty disturbing sex scene, but after, we see her going to some professional looking building. Turns out she is at that escort place owned by some Slavic people. This woman explains her little VIP sex business, but the sexual activity she will be doing seems pretty hardcore. Like stuff you would see in hardcore porn, not that I would know that, but she is led out to sit with these other girls who I'm guessing are younger than 18. Then a real creep comes in, saying clearly he will take this one, who looks obviously really, really young. After this explicit photo shoot, it seems she and this girl I'll call Sugar are about to do a job. Sugar really wants to be a porn star, explaining how doing this escort service is experience on his own. Once this client comes in, we get a montage of sex and threesomes that I definitely won't show. But after a rough day, she goes home only to cut herself again. But this act is interrupted by the creep, who is mad at her for smoking and cutting herself. He drags her outside and stuffs her into the pool like 3 times. Now, I'm sure in some way this hurts a lot more than we see, especially since when we usually saw her around water, she was at peace, not in pain. She leaves that place and waits outside Sugar's home, hoping to stay with her for a few days. The two girls basically become best friends, even taking on more jobs together, such as this very explicit stripping scene. There's a lot of vulgar scenes made worse, considering you are seeing a child. But regardless, it seems she always needs coke to cope. We then see the two girls take on a special job. They get picked up by this metalhead, who drives them all the way back home, brings them into his gloomy garage, and fixes some drinks. He forces Sugar to drink it, which makes her pass out. He then grabs and bounds Shara, forcing her to watch as he records himself taking advantage of her friend, saying, "You're next." After all that evil, the two girls are dropped off and sit together in anguish. The two girls return to the boss lady, who gives them two pairs of earrings instead of the $500 a piece they are owed. The sad part is that Shara's services are required again, and she is forced to sell her body again. To who though? To Jamie. He tracked her by an ad he saw her in, and he uses the opportunity to apologize for leaving her. Look, with all what he said, I would have never forgave him, even if he's trying to help now. Really, it seems like he just got down on his luck and feels regretful, but Shara forgives him. She says she can't leave, that they own her now. His words help give her the strength to at least come with him, and the next night, they plot to get the money she is owed for all the work she did. Jamie gets strapped and runs into the building to get the money. At gunpoint, he holds up the business, but the tables turn so fucking quick and drastic. Jamie knows that once that gun is to his head, it's over, and closes his eyes to accept his death, which we hear from two gunshots. We then see his body in the garbage, which is later discovered by a heavily disturbed Shara. So, Shara has literally nowhere to go now, and after breaking down, we see her back with her mom, prostituting themselves to that rich man from the beginning. We then see her step into a bathtub with her razor blades by her sides. She takes the razor blades and slices down her arm, letting herself die. She is eventually discovered dead by her mom, but her soul wanders, I guess, walking into the ocean and escaping the life she had. That's enough. Did I get the bad ending? I'm not finna replay this. What a damn bleak and messed up ending. I was hoping for at least a fighting chance, but it was just fucked up. Now it's easy to be like, why did she do that? Or why didn't she do this? We can't judge things based on our experience. But I know that if anybody out there is feeling like Shara, before she decided to finalize things, please talk to someone. Talking is extremely helpful, like you would not believe. She still had a full life ahead of her. Let's not follow that path. So, now that we got through that bleak film, let's talk about the most disturbed moment and most enjoyed moment in that spooky stuff. So let's get right into it. The most disturbed moment is probably the forced evil that Sugar and Shara ran into. It was hard to watch because it was definitely the breaking point for Shara. Well, a breaking point. The most enjoyed moment was probably the swim. Just the scene of her walking into the water. I hate that she had to kill herself to let go, but seeing her smile is what qualifies. And that's it. Now, if you feel like being saddened again by a similar story, then you could check out No Child of Mine, which is kind of like a precursor to this movie. Or you could lighten up by watching a vigilante played by Ellen Page who tortures a pedophile. Thanks for watching. Spooky out.